Give all honor, praise, and glory to our Heavenly Father, Yahweh. Also the true Holy Black beside the King of Kings, royalty himself, Yahweh Shah, Mashiach. Also the Father, Father, True Father, One West. This Father King's going to get you yet one of the lesson. Before I go forward in this lesson, lesson 10 and 2, the lost sheep of the house of Israel, which consists of the so-called blacks, so-called Latinos, and so-called Native American Indians, and also our Israelite foreigners that look like the other nations. Because you're going to have Israelites that look like every nation under the sun. That's why they call confusion a face, because you're going to have Israelites that look like every nation. It's not based off the color or skin tone of a person, but rather the heritage of their fathers when you read the book of Numbers. Yep, it goes into the heritage of their fathers. So it mentioned that they declared the house by the pedigree of their father, meaning that the lineages. So it goes back to your father, your forefather. You are who your forefather is. To you I say shalom and peace and blessings be unto you and the hopeful elect out there that's listening and learning. I'm going to go right into the title here. I'm going to title this lesson. I'm going to try to make the lesson very short. Prisoners of Hope. Yes, that's right. If you don't realize, the so-called black man, the so-called Latino man, the so-called Native American Indian man, we are in a prison, which is called Babylon the Great. In modern day terms, which is called USA, United States of America, because the Bible mentioned United States as Babylon. You know, the Bible speaks metaphorically and speaks in prophecy. And the only way you can understand that prophecy, you must be part of the elect to understand the prophecy, you know. So I want to touch on that we are hoping and praying that the days be shortened. Because why? We are in a prison. You so-called blacks, Latinos, Native American Indians, you are in what you call a social prison, a economically social prison, where you are attached to a debt, and that debt is attached to you, and you spend the rest of your life paying off that debt, which is attached to your social security number. Something that comes similar to it, they put it in a movie called The Matrix, you know, because the people who was not woke to the fact that they was in the Matrix. So we are in a digital prison, you know, and I believe they're going to come out with the MOTB, where they're going to try to chip people, because they are the wicked. Joel chapter 9 verse 24, Malachi chapter 1 verse 4, you know. But we are in a prison here. Let me get a couple of scriptures real quick. I want to read the book of Zechariah chapter 9 verse 12 verse 13, going right along with the lessons. And it quotes, "Turn you to the stronghold, ye prisoners of hope, even to the day I do declare that I will render a double unto thee, you know, and when I have bent Judah for me, fill the bow with Ephraim, and raise up the sons of Zion against thy son of Greece, and I made thee as the sword of a mighty man." So the point I want to touch on is, when you read right above the chapter, it says, Turn you to the stronghold, ye prisoners of hope. So we are prisoners of hope, you know. We are hoping and praying that we are the hopeful elect. As the scripture say, make sure you're calling the election sure. So we are praying and hoping that we get out of this captivity, you know. That's what the Bible says, that pray that the days be shortened. We're supposed to be praying that the days be short, because why? We are in a prison. We are in a digital prison, a social prison, which a debt slave. This prison we under is called debt slavery. If you don't believe me, look it up. The Bible speaks on we are still in our captivity. I'm going to read from the book of Baruch, chapter 3, verse 8. "Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity." So you understand why the Bible quoted that we are ye prisoners of hope. Because why? We are in captivity. America is a prison, whether you accept it or believe it or not. Try to leave this country without a passport, see how far you go. Try to live in a house without paying a mortgage, see how far you go. Try to live in a society without paying your taxes and see how far you go. Try to drive your car without paying your tax and registration for your license plate. See how far you go. Try to drive your car without paying a renewal for your driver license. Because you got to have a fee, I think, every 4 or 5 years, I think. Every 4 years, I believe. Don't hold me to it, but I believe every 4 years you have to pay a slight fee for to renew your license. Try to do all these things and try to leave this country, see how far you go. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity on top of mortgages. Because you have to pay a mortgage, which is another form of debt, which goes into debt slavery. Somebody might be simple, like, well, I can work a 9-to-5 job. Yeah, you can work a 9-to-5 job, but that's the money they already owe you from the Atlantic slave trade and the transatlantic slave trade, also the triangular slave trade, where they don't teach in school, by the way, because the triangular slave trade between England and France and America. Why everybody trying to vote for Kamala Harris? Yes, this country and France and I believe England made so much money that they had to contribute that wealth from the slave trade to the other countries. So before it was a triangular slave trade, before it was a transatlantic slave trade, there was a triangular slave trade. That's how America got most of its wealth. Behold, we are yet in this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us. James 1:1, to the 12 tribes that scattered abroad, greetings. Go right into the New Testament with that. Because you might have somebody listen to this class be like, okay, it's talking about the Old Testament. No, you go, the scriptures, precept must be on precept, here a little, there a little. The scriptures can't be broken, whether you read the Old Testament or the New Testament. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse to be subject to payment. Like I told you, we are in what you call debt slavery. You are constantly making payments to this man. You feel me? And you built everything. You invented everything. The cell phone that I'm on, or the computer that I'm on, the so-called Black, Latino, and Native American Indian man had contributed to that. All the inventions from the car. That's why Henry Ford, he never get credit for creating the car. He get credit for creating the assembly line in post-production and mass production, right? See, these things they're not going to teach in the schools because the schools are paid off to teach lies, to teach the Western philosophy of lies. And to be subject to payments according to all the iniquities of our fathers, which departed from the Lord, our power. And that's why we are subject to debt today, which we are a debt slave, subject to payments, which is another form of slavery. You know, whether people want to accept it, believe it or not, the so-called Black man, so-called Latino man, and so-called Native American Indian man, we are not free to this day. So anybody tell you that we are free, they are not among the elect, because the scripture says, we read Revelation 13, verse 9 and 10, it says, any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth in captivity, I want you to pay attention, brothers and sisters, he that leadeth in captivity should go into captivity. You know why I want to bring, you know why I brought that part of scripture out? When you read Father now, it says, here is the faith and the patience of the saints. Meaning when the King of Kings return, we are going to be in a form of captivity. And that captivity now is debt slavery. We are subject to payments. You know, when you punch the clock from 9 to 5, that is slavery. When you look up the legal word in the legal dictionary, the word employer means slave master, and the word employee means slave, you know? So, yeah. So I just want to touch on that. Title's lesson, ye prisoners of hope. So we hope and pray that the Most High deliver us.